For everyone that's keeping score, I have Old Pueblo Yard is now in place and usable. You can see it right there. I don't have all the drop feeders in yet, so we're running off of rail joiners. I'm right about here installing feeders right now in the layout, so I'll work my way around. But I've got tired of dropping feeders for a little bit of time and decided I want to run some trains. Here's the south yard, which is basically the engine service facility for Old Pueblo Yard, up and running. The transloading area right here. This is Adobe Pass. I'm not exactly sure what sort of industry I'm going to put right in this set of tracks here. It's probably going to be, some warehouse or something like that. Not sure what. And then down here is another little industry. I'm not sure what I'm going to put down here. Maybe a, farm type industry or something like that. I'm not sure. When I get that far, we'll do it. But here's where we're at. Turns out pretty nice. And the neat thing about having Old Pueblo Yard in place now is it just cleared out LaGrange. All these cars have been sitting up here for a long time waiting to get transferred and sorted down in Old Pueblo Yard. I moved them all out. It's kind of strange. Now the yard looks kind of empty. But this is LaGrange, and pretty much we get them down to here. That's where they're going to go. I have a transfer run, basically moving a bunch of cars out of Old Pueblo Yard. This is heading to Tucson, and we might as well follow this down in the Tucson. Here comes a transfer coming out of Old Pueblo. On the head end, we have, for power today, we have a GP40-6416. It looks like a GP7-6208. And another GP38-6049. As you can see with the GP40-6416, it's still in its colors at Rock Island. I believe that GP40 was purchased from the Rock Island when it went belly up. Looks like our train has got clearance for the main. It's going to be pulling out of the yard here in a minute. We're still within yard limits, so we're running at reduced speed. Right now you can see we're swinging around the RIP yard, the repair and place yard, right there. And there's about, it's like five cars need to be fixed. Catching up with our train right here. We're passing the service area. Those yellow ramps are for the sand towers, which aren't in place. And that gray flat, which you can barely see where we're passing right now, is the diesel fuel area. Looks like we're starting to pick up a little bit of speed here. Running up a transition onto the main. And from what I understand, we have clearance all the way down to Tucson. Making it around the south yard shops. Come around the back side. We have some MP15 sitting there on the main. Not sure what's going on. I think there's a track inspection crew or something. So we're back down to restricted speed, and we're taking the siding right in front of the corn syrup facility. You normally don't see this very much, a whole train taking a siding to clear a couple switchers. Train's going to head on out of Adobe Pass, and it's going to go around the turn, which is basically the loop outside the helix. Now that we're back on the main, I think we can pick up a little bit of speed. Here comes our train. It's coming down the backside of the turnaround, the helix. On our right, we have Green Valley with fruit of grain and valley growers. On the left is Basin. Eventually there will be a divider between the two so you can't see through. But for now, this is what we have. Train's running through what I call split helix. This is the upper section of the split helix. The lower section is right before the staging yard. But it's a simple way to get extra height in the layout without having a helix on top of each other. So I split it into two smaller sections. We're coming out of the tunnel now, heading into Basin, which is the home of Blue Circle Cement. Here we get a better view of Blue Circle Cement. Up there with the yellow tank car is that safety clean oil waste. And on the left on that upper loop is where we came down earlier. Here we got to hold up and get clearance from the Tucson Yardmaster to let us in the staging. I'm going to select the Tucson staging track since I'm the Yardmaster, macro 252. And here the tortoise is running. So pretty much I say we have clearance. So we're going to run the train right down through the lower half of the split helix. And the split helix basically wraps around the main helix. And if you look up, which is hard to see, I'll put my finger here, this is where that turn is where we came around earlier. Now in the real world, this staging represents both Phoenix and Tucson. Basically, we're coming in on the Tucson track right now. Everything that goes in and out of Tucson runs on that far right track. The two tracks that lead underneath that lower helix to the left represent things coming out of Phoenix, and they actually climb the main helix up to the top deck for LaGrange. The staging is basically what they call a loop staging. You have the main outer track, which runs the entire distance, and everything comes in through the one end, pointing in the same direction, heading out. So if you look right here, you can see trains all lined up, ready to hit the layout again. Santa Fe, Southern Pacific, and Gila Springs, Mesquite. Santa Fe from Phoenix, Southern Pacific from Tucson, and GS&M either end. Our train's pulling up into the main processing area of our staging yard. Basically, who's ever running staging, we'll find the train and put the cars right here. We'll stop the train like we're going to do now. Oops, that wasn't actually stop. decide the length of the train, and then we'll select an empty staging track for it. I have cards that represent each staging track and how long they are. They're just not here right now. So pretty much I'm just going to go ahead and select staging track. So we'll select macro 201. You can hear the switch motors running. And I'll put this in the 201. And that again was a reverse loop click. So as it works its way around, if I bring it up around, it'll be heading the other direction of the reverse loop, and it'll enter this area of the staging tracks, heading back into the mini helix and the main helix to end up back in the main layout area. Hope you enjoyed the ride. Watch for further updates on the layout.